Okay.
So guys, this is Charlie Gar introducing my radio interview as Heard of Him Today. Hope you enjoy it and thanks for supporting my music.
Good morning, Ed and Rachel here. Welcome, it's Heart Breakfast Monday morning. Very exciting news now. We bring you some brand new talent from Bromsgrove. She's going to be absolutely massive. Here she is, it's China Girl in the studio with us.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm great, thank you.
Good.
Yeah.
Now this is our chance to introduce you to the world, China Girl. So tell us a little bit about yourself. How did you get going with this singer-songwriter stuff?
Well, ever since I went to college and studied art and loved it all, and I got a bit obsessed with Alice in Wonderland, and I started writing when I was about 16, just all these crazy little pop numbers about sort of all sorts of things, you know, lollipops, candy sticks, all the crazy
perfect
stuff. Yeah, all a bit wild really, rock and roll. But I really enjoy writing, so I've been doing it for years, and it's just got to a point now where I feel like it's ready for people to start listening to and understanding.
You're pretty unique, but who inspires you? Who in the music world right now makes you think they're cool, they know where it's at?
Right, okay. Directly, like, musicians-wise, there's nobody that I think in pop music now is really kind of doing what I want to do,
right,
and I aspire to, which I know is a bit controversial saying that. There's this movement called the Waffles Girls, and they just do all sorts of crazy stuff, taking pictures and going on wild parties and stuff, and just kind of living the dream that every little girl wants to live. So I'm not so much going for something that another artist is doing. I'm trying to create a whole new world for people to relate to and to see music in a different light, really.
So what can people expect from you? Because your voice is fairly outstanding, isn't it, and unusual. What can people expect from your album?
Yeah, well, I used to do a lot of soul singing, so those are where my roots come from, so I still want to keep that soul in my voice. At the same time, it's quite childlike and kiddie, because I think that's what little girls will hear and relate to and think sounds really cool and quirky. It's about writing music that kids can listen to and feel, oh, I wish I was that person, that gives me an identity and a stamp and something that I can listen to every day and wear and, you know, and be a part of the whole China Girl thing and have a little escape to the Wonderland. And it's all just really exciting for them.
So here we go then, cast your mind forward 12 months from now. Where do you want to be?
For me, it's never really been about being famous. It's about finding myself, as cheesy as that sounds, and understanding myself. And I know as a kid it's really hard growing up now, and there's a lot of gloom and doom, and I just want it to be all fun and exciting and sparkly and just really happy again. And, you know, I hope that I want to be the music. I don't just want to be an artist that people listen to. I want to be the music, you know. So when I'm out there singing, people are looking at me, imagine they're up there with me singing as well. So I hope to do great things.
When and how can people get their hands on your stuff, China Girl?
Well, we're writing the album as we speak. The ideas have been going for years and years, so, you know, it's sort of getting to the point now we're writing some really amazing little cute pop R&B numbers. And I'm hoping they'll be upcoming next year, so
wow,
summertime. So, yeah, it's pretty exciting.
Lovely stuff. Well, thank you very much for coming on the show. Really
cool.
Nice to meet you, and we look forward to seeing China Girl's name in massive lights everywhere in the next year or so.
All the best with everything.
Thank you very
China
much.
China Girl on Heart Breakfast. Thank you. Then we be moving as fast as a NASCAR ride, switch gears, slow down.